Hi, I'm meteorologist Chris Tomer. Let's talk mountain weather and ski conditions. And we have snow falling in Colorado. Let's take a live look. This is Loveland Ski Area, where I think we'll end up, with 5-6 inches of new snow up there. By the time the storm is over, you can see the lift running up to the top of the Continental Divide at over 12,000. The snow is coming down up there. This is awesome to see. We need the snow so badly in Colorado. So let's go into the analysis here. I'll show you what's going on. You can definitely see there are two things that catch your eye. First of all, we've got the low pressure, which is sitting right here, and that will continue to slide through Colorado and lay down snow on its way out. And there's another low out here, which is off the west coast. Now, what that one is going to do is drop south, eventually move into the Intermountain West, and basically run into this large dome of high pressure and just disintegrate. So I'll show you all that. Let me take you in just a little bit closer here to the four corners. And blue is snow on this. We've got snow. There was a little bit that did brush up against parts of the Wasatch in Utah. Southern Utah got more though. Looking at New Mexico getting snow through Taos. And then, of course, you've got the snow in Colorado. All right, let's get into the forecast aspect of this. And what I want to do is take a look at the jet stream and notice the big ridge. The polar jet is way up into Canada, so that's a non-factor. This storm that's coming in on the southern branch, and I'll mark it here, there's your southern branch right there, which is escorting this almost cutoff low from the main jet into the desert southwest is warmer. And so that is having an effect as well. It's a little different, a little heavier type of snow for the four corners. But nonetheless, that storm is being moved in on the jet stream. And that is actually today. All right, here's the jet moving forward. So that low I showed you off the coast basically becomes this. It becomes pinched by the jet and almost closes off. This storm runs into basically that ridge of high pressure, and it just gives up. It's almost sacrificial. And that will set the stage, though, I think I talked about this yesterday, for a larger storm and dip in the jet to have a better chance of coming in Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday of next week. And you can see that on the clock right there. It's Tuesday. Here's your bigger low pressure. And there'll actually be, I think, two different low pressures that ride this dip in the jet stream in for Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday of next week. That's a much better pattern for all of the West, in fact. Here's our future radar. There's your current situation. As we roll into Friday morning here, you can see that storm exits out of Colorado. Now we'll look to the west coast and see what this low pressure does. But again, that's going to run into a pretty strong area of high pressure. There is going to be some snow, northern Cal down into Tahoe. But then that, again, it's almost like it just completely disappears. It rolls into Utah and Colorado and hits that dry air and that high, and it's done. I will say that over the next couple of days, we're going to see some pretty good snow up in Whistler, Blackcomb. So if you're looking for another alternative place to ski for new snow, look at British Columbia. Okay, so this is Sunday morning. Notice the next low coming in. And again, the flow is really strong up into British Columbia all the way into, in fact, Sunday and maybe into Monday too. Here's the pattern, the change coming for next week. So this is Tuesday morning on the clock. And what we're seeing is basically an influx of moisture into the interior. That is as that larger dip in the jet stream comes in next week. So there you go. There's 5 a.m. on Wednesday. We've got a nice little sort of corridor of snow wrapping itself in from Big Sky, which I think will do well out of this pattern. This is Wednesday at 5, and you've got all that moisture sliding in. Let's look at accumulation here. And as we kind of roll into tomorrow, look at Whistler. They've come up to almost the foot mark. And look at the numbers in Colorado. Tomorrow will be a good day to ski Colorado, mainly up on the Continental Divide up there, Loveland and Winter Park, A Basin. Those areas will do very well. Now, that storm then exits, so the totals by Saturday, you're going to have to look to the west coast. Look at Whistler up at 2 feet by the time we get into Saturday morning of accumulated snowfall and starting to add some down through Shasta as well. All right, let's go from Saturday into Sunday morning and notice what happens. Not a lot. We're just waiting on that next west coast storm to begin to have an effect. So between Sunday, Sunday afternoon, Sunday night, here it comes. Whistler goes up, Baker goes up. We start to see the numbers tick up through Schweitzer. And watch between Monday and Tuesday. Look at the numbers come up through Discovery and Sun Valley. There'll be a couple of effects from this west coast storm as all that moisture starts to come into the west. We'll finish up here on Wednesday morning. And watch the numbers come up. Look at Big Sky and Bridger Bowl. I think also there's, I think the number for Jackson is going to be higher than this by Wednesday morning. We've added a bit through Squaw down to Mammoth, and we started to add some into parts of Colorado as well. So this is good. While it's very isolated pockets now, by the time we get into Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday of next week, the numbers become much more widespread. The snow totals start to go up in more places. All right, so thank you for tuning in here, and I'll keep things updated as we head into the weekend. Take care. Have a good day.